This is absurd.
We haven't got much choice.
How many days have we been doing this?
I've lost track.
We could count the layers of dirt.
Or the scratches on our hands.
I don't see how we can keep this up much longer.
The targets are too high. We can't stop.
The shafts aren't safe. We haven't fully stabilized them.
There wasn't the time. If we had, then we'd never have met the last target.
And if it collapses on us, we'll stop meeting any of them.
Which color is it again?
Your memory is terrible. Why do I have to keep explaining this?
Just humor me, Fyodor. I've been down here much longer than you.
You can't exactly use your age as an excuse.
It affects you, being down here.
That I agree with. The Aussie plane is orange. Polyphobon is green.
Not the other way around?
What does it matter? You find either, you dig it out.
They don't even sound like real things.
I've never heard of them either. But who are we to question? You know what happens if you disobey.
And you're right. We're going too deep. You can feel the roof starting to give way. I'll send for more support.
Hey, wait a minute. I've got something. Yes, I've got something!
You sure have. Still, that green light is eerie.
Rocks and minerals don't normally give off light.
Do you think it's dangerous?
Deep in the earth, glowing green? Quite probably. Let's get it out quick. That should see us clear for a bit. You could help me, you know.
Did you see that?
See what?
I thought I saw...
More of it? Where?
No, I thought I saw something down here with us.
It's just us two down here. I know there isn't much light, but there's hardly anywhere anyone could hide. We're in the mineshaft, Kiro. We could hear someone coming.
I thought... Never mind. Let's get this out, then support this shaft. Tell me you saw that.
What was it?
It looked like a mole or something. Shiny.
Sure it wasn't a trick of the green light?
I saw it. I definitely saw it. There's something down here with us.
Doctor? Are you there, Doctor? Don't make me go searching through all the console rooms again. It's no use hiding from me. Well, if you insist. So that's what he is. Right then. And for my next trick...
What? This is certainly not right. How in the name of Gallifrey am I here?
Ah, there you are.
What have you done?
Absolutely nothing. I just got here myself.
What have you touched?
Hook me up to a lie detector. I'm telling the truth. I've done nothing. Believe what you want, Doctor.
I'll do just that. I was in the library.
Okay.
Catching up on my reading.
Anything good?
The opening chapters of Dracula are a personal favorite of mine, and I figure I could do with a bit of a treat. We haven't had the best of times recently.
We clearly have different definitions of treats.
I see an aberration of styles deficient in you.
I have good taste, if that's what you're saying. Look at what I'm wearing, and then at you. Clothes speak for themselves.
What you see, the corridor outside the library simply doesn't lead to the console room. Not this one, anyway. How did I get here?
I've already told you, I don't know. Maybe you don't know this place as well as you claim.
And where did you sneak off to, Antoine? Not meddling in the affairs of my ship, I hope.
I fancied a swim. That isn't a crime.
And did you enjoy yourself?
Oh, very much. Thank you for asking. Though I must admit, I didn't expect to find a beach in here. That truly takes bigger on the inside to a whole new level.
Thank you for not dragging sand into my console room. Have you quite finished exploring my TARDIS? Am I free to pilot us somewhere interesting?
Your ship, your rules.
And I've been so wonderfully inspired. I was sat reading and I thought to myself, Doctor, have you ever gone back and met Bram Stoker? No, I don't think you have.
Do you often have internal conversations like that?
Well, you forget. I have lived many lives, and there are remnants of each in my head. I can talk to my other selves when I wish. I admit, it can get a tad confusing, but I do make myself laugh sometimes.
So you want us to go...
To meet the creator of Dracula. What do you say?
Well, I hate to be the negative one, but based on everything we've been through so far, the last thing we need is to go and visit one of the writers that put vampires on the map. Knowing our luck, we'll end up living through the book. I'll be Harker and you can be Van Helsing.
I see what you're getting at.
How about we inspire him another day, eh?
I'll log that in my to-do list.
Back to the drawing board, then. Let's have a think, shall we? Where would be a fun little trip? Bombay, 1972? California, 1852? Paris, 1941? Anything take your fancy? The hallucinatory poetry of a city living on an opiate squalor? The gold lust of the American frontier? Rebellion against foreign oppressors?
My, my. You do have some spirit.
Who said anything about limiting it to Earth? I know you do seem to have something of a penchant for the planet, but how about a little further afield? The archipelago of the Broken Rhyme? The tumble-down mountains on the Caroline 7? Sourdough City on Lentos Buran?
So much choice! You know what helps in situations like this? A nice cup of plutonian coffee. I'll go make us some, shall I? Stay right there. What was that?
What was what?
Oh, look, the corridors have brightened themselves again. Probably need to have the internal configuration circuits looked at.
He can't possibly be that naive. Let's keep the danger to a minimum, eh? As fun as it is. So, why don't we leave it up to you as to where we go next? You seem to be a good judge of character. I mean, we get along, don't we? I'm getting as bad as him now I'm talking to you. He's rubbing off on me.
Something bizarre is going on. What's gotten into you, my dear?
Ah!
Oh, Antoine, you might want to blow on that first. Rather hard. But that's how the Plutonians like it.
Thanks.
How about a nice slice of human history? I never tire of Earth and all its wonders and mysteries.
What a surprise. I'm happy to follow you.
I'm not some trans-temporal tour guide. Shall we say the Midlothian campaign?
Are we talking war or politics?
British politics.
Riveting.
It's a series of speeches William Gladstone made, 1878 to 1880. We can witness the heart of the British political system in person.
As important as they might have been, isn't there somewhat a bit more, how can I put this delicately, more exciting?
These speeches were crucial for the formation of the country.
Most politicians are crucial to the formation of their country, just not always in a good way.
I offer you culture. You tell me it's too exciting. I offer you societal development. Not exciting enough. If we're going to travel together, I propose offering this as an education to you, young man.
I know enough to get by.
But think of what you're missing out on.
You underestimate me, Doctor.
I'd rather keep an eye on you.
You don't trust me?
I don't think I know you yet. We might have been together for a fair time now, but I don't feel that I know you. Perhaps the two of us need to sit down and talk things through.
You want me to leave?
I somehow doubt it would be that easy to get rid of you, Antoine.
I'll take that as a compliment.
I'm going to consult my star charts. Find us somewhere peaceful. Take a bit of time off. This animosity is no good for traveling companions.
Exactly. Okay, take us down somewhere now. You had already put the coordinates in, you sly old man. Well done, very well done. But, change of plan, you know how these things go. Wonderfully temperamental ships doing just what they want. Oh, come now, play nicely. Find us somewhere to keep him distracted for a bit. I won't be around too much longer, I promise. We both have his best interests at heart. So let's find somewhere stimulating, but not too over the top. I know you can do it. Oh, that's bad. You're trying to warn me? But of what? Ugh, of course. You can't actually hear me. Tell me that wasn't me.
What is going on now?
Turbulence?
I shouldn't leave you alone in here.
I don't need a babysitter. Can you fix this?
Fix? There's a hole in the time vortex. Well, that isn't right. It can't be.
Need help?
I can do this. And now for my next trick.
Magic.
I know how to control my ship is all. Our little chat can wait. Someone has created a massive hole in the vortex. That's a definite no-no.
Not more time experiments. I'm sick of them.
You haven't been doing this half as long as I have. Fingers crossed for a gentle landing.
I have faith in you.
Who knows how much damage that did? Some careless idiot messing around with things they don't understand.
We're going to Earth, aren't we?
Well, for their sake, I certainly hope not.
Hardly very impressive. Looks like a quarry.
Too flat for that.
So says the expert. So, Earth?
Of course. I'm always telling them not to muck about with time.
Seems they're the ones needing a childminder.
We'd best take a look around. Start with those warehouses.
They look empty.
Ah, clearly not in use anymore. Perfect place for secret, dangerous experiments.
I can't see anything.
How disappointing. I thought this would be a simple, open and shut thing.
I don't suppose they'd be hiding in the corner or something.
Well, they couldn't hide the equipment that easily now, could they? To rip a hole in the vortex would require colossal energy reserves, equipment that would practically fill this place.
Maybe they don't know they're doing it. What if it's an unexpected consequence of whatever they're doing?
Well, ignorance is no excuse.
Oh, I know that. Just postulating. Time to move on? Wait, did you hear that?
Probably rats.
Do you think they saw us?
They can't have. They'd have taken us with them if they had.
Georgie, we can't live like this.
I know you're scared. We all are.
People keep coming here. They must know about us.
We're safe. For now.
I'd hardly call this safe. Remember where we are. When we are.
I don't know what you want me to do. I can't magic up a time machine, Daryl. We're stuck here.
Why did this have to be so tall?
You wanted to climb it, so you wanted to see what was on the other side.
Well, it seemed like a better idea at the bottom.
Next time you want to get over a mound of dirt, I'll let you go first.
Nearly there now.
Ah, not so bad an idea after all.
Well, would you look at that? Looks like we have ourselves an industrial town of sorts. Yes, I'm sure of it.
They look new. Well, relatively speaking.
I'd say they recently built. But that level of development, it's rather quick. Impressive, wouldn't you say, Antoine?
Especially for the time. We must be in the 20th century? 30s or 40s?
Seems logical. Look at that building over there. I can't make it all out, but that first word, astomat. That must be what this place is called. Let me think.
Russia.
Thank you, but I didn't need the hint. Quite near the larger city of Irkutsk.
30s, I'm sure of it. Just look at the architecture. But we can't have hit the Second World War just yet. You know what that means. Stalin, 5-year plans, industrial advancement on a phenomenal scale.
Yes, I know that, but how come you do?
Ha, no reason really. Just one of those eras I took more interest in. You know how it goes.
I'll pretend that I do.
You must have your favorite periods.
But you haven't shown half the interest in this planet that I have. I do wonder about you, though. I still think I trust you. Would I be wrong to do so?
Doctor?
Hmm?
Watch out.
What for?
Them. Doctor, where have you gone?
Over here.
Over where? I can't see you.
Follow me.
They don't know where you are. Hey, get out of my way. I've lost my...
Oh dear, oh dear. I do hope young Antoine won't get too lost. The last way I want to spend my afternoon is trying to find that rascal. Messing about with the internal logistics of my ship? I'll need to have a proper word with him about respecting my property. I'm wandering off into history so very much like him. Now, where have I ended up? Astomat. Astomat Factory. I wonder what you do in here. And by the looks of things, another shift is about to begin.
Hey, you.
So, where should I go? Maybe that young fellow had a good point. Perhaps I should stop talking to myself, at least when there's only one of me about.
Hey, you over there.
Now just who is he trying to get the attention of?
You in the silly hat.
Who? Me?
Yes, you.
I'm not wearing a silly hat. This is stylish.
It doesn't matter. Get to work.
Pardon?
You heard. Get to work. The shift's already started. Get going.
Ah, I see what's going on here.
You do? Who?
It's a simple case of mistaken identity. I'm not a laborer.
Oh, yeah? I've heard that one before.
All the more reason to listen to me.
They all say stuff like that. All these silly little excuses to get out of a hard day's work. And do you know what? I'm having none of it. You're younger than you look. You can still work.
There was a compliment in there somewhere.
Come on. I don't have all day.
No, sir. You see, I'm actually, well, an official of the Soviet Union. I'm here as a representative of Stalin himself. Here to oversee just what this place is doing. You understand, I'm here to work technically. And yes, it is to the same end as you, but without the physical part.
Right. You got any paperwork to back that up?
It's all in my transport.
And I'm just supposed to take your word for all this.
Or, you could put me to work and face the rather horrible consequences of your mistake. Tell me, how many men have you seen dressed like me?
Not so many, that's for sure.
Precisely. Now, if you have nothing else to be doing...
Yes, of course, sir.
Thank you. On your way, then. Phew. Maybe not the best of lies to tell, but needs must. How about we have a brief explore before getting back to Antoine? It isn't every day you have such access to history. Oh, dear man. Are you all right? No, it's quite clear you aren't. You're barely conscious. Come, you need to rest. Your pulse is faint. When was the last time you had something to eat? Or drink? Ah, but you don't seem to want to talk. Cracked lips, thin frame, heavy breathing. Well, this does not look good. Here, take this. Trust me, please. There. Now, you need to rest. I tell you not to argue, but I highly doubt you're going to. How about we rest your head on... Well, I can only offer you that pile of ground, or a spanner. I know which I'd rather have. You should be all right around here. Nobody should find you. Sweet dreams. I always told my friends to show respect towards history, but maybe not today. No, not today. This is truly horrendous. Truly abhorrent. And only a speck of this day, only the slightest pixel of the overall image. There's so much more to see, and I don't think I want to see any of it. That's the problem with time travel. Some parts of history cannot be altered. Not one jot. And that includes the beginnings of Stalinist Russia. The tunnel will get darker, my friend. But there is an end to it. Just not now. I feel any further exploration will only end in sadness. Oh, now which way was to my TARDIS, hmm? Although, what do we have here? This is most curious. How could they have got their hands on these? Well, those drills, that scanner. They are most certainly not of this time period. This isn't simply out of place for the 1930s. This would be revolutionary for the 2130s. And there's that horrible feeling again. There's something unpleasant I'm going to have to get involved in here, isn't there? Well then, perhaps there's a little clue in this technology.
What do you two want?
We've just got out of the mines. We had a promising find.
Of what?
Polyphobon. Whatever you want it for, we've got loads of it. Seems like we hit a vein down there. The others are digging it out now.
Curious. Most curious.
So you're going to send us more men?
You don't need them. There are enough. If you two were still down there, then it would get done a lot quicker. Go on. Back to it.
Thanks for nothing.
And none of that either. You haven't got all day.
I'm sure he said polyphobone. But that is absurdity personified. Why on earth would they want that 400 years before it would be of any use to them? I'm terribly sorry to bother you. I understand that you're both rather busy with mining and your other associated tasks, but I was hoping I might ask you a couple of questions. It'll only take a few minutes.
And you are?
The doctor, of course. Were you expecting someone else?
So shouldn't you be helping us rather than the other way around?
Not in the medical sense. Why? Is something wrong?
Not in the medical sense.
What do you want to know?
Polyphobone.
What about it?
What do you know about it?
What it looks like? What color it is?
And do you understand its properties?
No. Never heard of this stuff till I got here. We're just told to get this stuff.
But it makes no sense. It has limited potential. Why are you mining for it?
To keep our jobs?
Doctor, they tell us do this and never deem it necessary to explain why. We do as we're told because we didn't exactly have a choice.
I am sorry.
Your pity is meaningless.
Well, it's history. This is the way it was. I don't know if there's anything I can do to help you.
So you can't tell us why we're just ignoring everything we looked for in the past for these apparently useless ores?
Not yet, but I intend to find out.
Doctor, there you are.
I've always been here, young man. You've just been looking in the wrong places.
Where did you say your transport was?
Out there somewhere. I can't remember precisely.
Well, nobody seems to know where it is. In fact, nobody has seen anything come anywhere near the factory recently.
How peculiar.
Your answer to that?
And what, good fellow, are you accusing me of? Are you sure it's a wise course of action?
I have no proof of your identity. Just your word.
Prove that I'm not telling you the truth. It'll only take one call. But I think we both know what the outcome would be for the both of us.
All right, Doctor.
Hmm?
The way I see it, it isn't worth my life if you're lying.
Ah.
You understand.
Of course. Go ahead. I can wait here with these two gentlemen. I'm sorry I didn't catch your names.
Kirill and Fyodor.
Thank you. I'm sure you know these two men, good sir. Here's what I propose. I shall stay here under their supervision. You can go and make a fool of yourself, and I won't move an inch. But should I try to go anywhere, I recommend instructing these loyal workers, Kirill and Fyodor, to restrain me in any way they see fit.
Seriously?
Well, they're younger, stronger, fitter than me. Be fair, I can hardly outrun them. And these tools would act as a mighty deterrent. What idiot would try to get away from men armed with makeshift weapons like that?
We could kill a man with these, you know that?
Well, of course I do. That's the whole point. Your foreman can go and sort everything out, and then return to this exact point to apologize for such disappointing behavior, safe in the knowledge that I won't have budged. Well, what are you waiting for? I don't have all the time in the world. I'm sure that we would have enthralling conversations here, but as you said, these men have work to be getting on with, and so do we. So, let's not dilly-dally any longer. Make the call.
Doctor, if you'd follow me...
Follow you where?
I have a vehicle waiting for you. It's going to take you to the local office. I'm sorry for any confusion caused.
Oh, there is no need.
I insist. It's the least I can do for this little occurrence.
Say no more. Say no more. It's completely forgotten.
Doctor, this way, if you please.
You insist?
I do.
Lead on.
And you too.
We're going.
Right then. Doctor, can you hear me? Where are you? It just goes to show you can't let that wretched man out of my sight for an instant. Always wandering off. I'm sure he's used that commotion as an excuse to explore. Just like him to pretend to get caught up in the crowd and go where it takes him. Feel free to abandon me, Doctor. I can look after myself. Jolly looking place this. Nothing much to look at. Ah, history. Why do you have to be such a disappointment? I expected more color traveling with the Doctor out of this dull, dusty landscape. And if we are where we think we are, I'm not sure I want to be just hanging around out in the open. If he has any sense, he'll do just the same. Back to the TARDIS. Regroup and replan. I like the sound of that. The walk shouldn't take too long. Looks like I found myself a shortcut. Seems like it might be a good day after all. Could that box be any more blue? It sticks out so very, very much. I'm off with a retro look, but in the middle of a desert it looks so silly.
nothing about. That warehouse was empty earlier, but there's definitely someone moving about in there. I should just go into the TARDIS and wait it out. I should not investigate. I should not. But of course.
Hey, you in there! Ready or not, here I come! So, if we could not play hide and seek, I'd greatly appreciate it. Oh, come on. I know you're in here. I'm not scary. I won't bite you, so you can come out of your little hiding places and say hello. And yet you're still cautious. Time for plan B. Shall we play the honesty game? I'll tell you exactly who I am, and then you can do the same. My name? Well, my name is Anton. I don't actually belong here, I don't live here, and I'm not connected with the authorities in any way at all. Just look at me, if you can. No uniform, no weapons, just casual little me. Still not convinced? Doctor? You aren't just mucking about back there, are you? Shame. That would have been far more easier. Okay, more truths. I travel with a man called the Doctor, and he's great at helping people out in difficult situations, and to be fair, I'm not half bad myself. We go from place to place righting wrongs and doing a lot of running. It's good cardio. Still nothing? Okay, one last try. But in telling you this, I make myself somewhat vulnerable. Mostly to ridicule based on this time period. We traveled in time in a blue box. You've probably seen it. It's parked outside. And it's a time and space machine with an anachronistic disguise. Well, that said, it might have something similar in England right about now. It's bigger...
You're from the future.
Ah, hello, disembodied voice. Something like that? Yes. Why, do you ask?
We don't belong here, either.
Would you mind terribly coming out? I enjoy having a face to the voice.
Antoine, is it?
That is indeed what I go by. And you are?
Don't move. We've got you surrounded.
A friendly welcome. Where were you guys when I first came in? Feels like a surprise party in here, just a little more aggressive and on edge than usual. If it's okay with you chaps, I'm going to carry on talking to your female friend.
My name is Georgie.
A little bit of fuss goes a long way. What a treat to meet you, Georgie. How about you tell me about you and your ragtag band of miscreants?
Oi!
Look at you with your broken plank of wood. You look like a teenager bent on causing damage to someone else's property, so not properly threatening. And the dirt on your face. Are we talking Peter Pan's Wild Boys, or war paint, or just plain mucky?
I could still whack you pretty hard.
Georgie, would you tell this idiot to get out of my face before I hurt him? I am more than capable.
Daryl, leave him alone.
But what if he's a spy?
Not a Russian spy. They don't tend to admit absurd things like time travel.
So you weren't being honest?
Absurd to someone of this time. Well, to most people, unless they've experienced it. You know I'm not a threat. You can tell you're clever.
He has a point. If he was lying, he'd have shot or threatened us by now.
He did threaten me.
You started it.
Childish.
Play nicely. We need as many allies as we can get. You know what we're dealing with.
I'm starting to get an impression.
You were in that box. And it came with you. I was in my private jet, and that got left behind.
That box is a ship, a spaceship.
Yeah, well, I was in my cab. Then bang! I was falling.
Falling?
That's how we ended up here. We fell.
Through time. You fell through time. You said you don't belong here.
I'm a businesswoman. British.
From Windsor. You don't belong in Stalinist Russia.
None of us do.
I'm from the 21st century. Now that isn't a sentence you normally find yourself saying. Georgie Darlington Cook.
Don't know who you are, but that hardly matters.
I was born in 56. But I suppose I haven't been born yet. That's messed up.
You must have fallen through the same hole in time that we did.
That sounds bad.
Of course it is. There shouldn't be holes in the vortex. Look, the doctor isn't going to want to leave until we've sorted this out and set his beloved web of time right, so it looks like I'm going to be sticking around for a while. So what I'm saying is...
You can help us?
I'll try.
You're the only hope we've got. Don't let us down.
Understood. You can hear that, right?
Where's it coming from?
The ground. It's the ground. Can't you feel it vibrating?
Something's blowing its way to the surface.
What is that?
Looks like a mole.
But it's metal. How many metallic moles have you seen before?
I said looks like, not is. What's it doing?
It's watching us. Look at the front of it. Are those things eyes?
Probably more like a camera. I'm going to get a better look.
What? Why?
Because it doesn't belong here either, obviously. You're never going to find any answers if you just hide in a warehouse. Stay still! Did you see where it went?
Over to the doors!
Well, what are you waiting for?
No way.
You're right. It isn't even from my time. My time. Coming, Antoine?
You shall not be here. You are to follow me port for work. Escape is impossible. We are armed.
Any grand plans?
We are to report for work. Then we escape and figure out what that thing was.
There's absolutely no need to walk me inside. I know the way from here. If you would please let go of my arm, I do not need an escort.
Thank you. That will be all. Thank you very much. Right then. Am I now to be allowed free rein to work as I was and continue my investigation for our wonderful country? Or is there another individual who believes they have the right to tamper with my behavior?
You, by the door. The man in the hat.
What is it about this hat? Everybody is commenting on it. I'm sorry for causing such disturbance.
Might I have a word?
To what end?
A word on your paperwork.
Well, I could do with a good chat. Nobody here strikes me as being all that talkative. Just barking orders and living to the letter of the law.
Not a criticism, I trust?
I wouldn't dream of it.
My name is Solian.
I'm the doctor. Delighted to meet you.
You are new to the area. We weren't expecting any visitors.
I'm all in favor of a good surprise.
Well, if I might say, you are the sort of surprise we'd prefer to encounter.
I can imagine. It does seem tense here.
Everybody is wary of targets. That's just how it is.
Tell me, anything of interest going on?
What are you looking to hear, Doctor?
I've been to the factory.
So you've already had a guided tour of our little town?
Not exactly. But there were things there that, shall we say, piqued my curiosity.
Not my department, I'm afraid.
So, nothing peculiar has come across your desk?
I wouldn't know what sort of thing you were thinking of.
I see.
If there's anything else you need, I'm sure someone else here can help you. I have somewhere else to be.
They're too afraid to speak out. Wretched history. I truly despise times like these. Hang about, what's this? He left me a note, how crafty. What have we got here? Doctor, you must know how dangerous questions are, especially in a place like this. But I have wondered the same things about you. I've had the same concerns. I've made certain discoveries that I believe might interest you. But this cannot be discussed here. You'll figure out where to find me. So Yang, how curious. And terribly lucky that my TARDIS can still translate the written word. It normally has a little trouble with the Cyrillic alphabet. So then, my friend, your answers will go terribly well with my questions.
Our suspicions have been confirmed. A great state does not need men like Solian. That traitor will be purged.
Where are you taking me?
There's no need to play dumb.
Oddly enough, I'm not pretending. A genuine response would be appreciated.
You're going down the mines.
You're kidding. So I suppose I'll be a 39er? Or is the American history reference lost on you? What about the woman I was with, Georgie? Where is she gone?
That's none of your concern. I'm putting you with Kirill and Fyodor. They're two of my best.
Don't worry, I'll have picked up the ropes in no time. Only little cramped here.
Who is this guy?
Right, let's not waste time. The sooner we found your, you know, those minerals or whatever, your diorzy whatnot and polyphonic, then we can get out of here, yes? Oh, I don't like those faces. You mean we hit our targets and we keep going?
Sadly.
Then they see that we've done well today, bump our next target up, and we don't stand a chance.
He gets it.
When you're stuck between a rock and a hard place...
Get out of the mine.
Exactly. Can't we speed this up? Where's the tracer? I'm sure I could. No, we don't have them yet. Divining rod?
Isn't that for water?
Same principle.
This is going to be hard work.
Ah, come on, Kirill. Fyodor. How about we dig for victory? Oh wait, I'm getting ahead of myself again. Ugh, how do you manage like this?
You don't exactly have much choice.
Just be careful where you put yourself. There isn't a room to be stretching down here, so...
Careful, gotcha. So what do these things look like?
You'll know them when you see them.
It's the thing that doesn't look like dirt.
Like this? It's only faint, but that has to be promising.
Budge up, let me help. Looks like the Ozeblame. This is what we're after. Well done, Antoine. Despite everything, looks like you're a natural.
Me? I'm a quick learner.
Try not to keep this up, though. Last thing we need is an overachiever. Unless you want to die down here.
I don't really need to respond to that, I hope.
There we are. Nice little bit there. Nothing too much, but definitely going in the right direction.
May I? It's heavier than I expected. Curious. Oh, I'm rather proud of myself. Time for a pat on the back.
Pass it here.
No need to be jealous, the day is still young.
How can you take this so lightly? This is real life, not some stupid joke.
I'm sorry, just trying to stay positive.
Leave him alone, Kiro. This place hasn't drained him yet.
Yet.
Yet? Not at all if we can get away with it.
Keep digging, Antoine.
What happened to my deoxy rock? Did you just pocket it?
Please tell me he's wrong.
So what if I did?
You know what'll happen if you get caught.
Death? Is there a need to be so brutal?
They think so.
Give it back, Kiro.
I don't understand. Why are you doing this?
And I thought you were smart. Take a guess, stranger.
Oh, money.
Precisely. I get this out of here, I can sell it on the black market and make some actual money for a change. Not a pittance that we can barely live by, but proper money.
You can't sell this stuff on the black market.
It has to have value. Why else would we be going to such lengths to get it? I'm going to buy my way out of here. Get away from this hellhole.
Maybe that isn't such a terrible idea.
Not you as well.
How else do you get out of here?
When they bury you.
So maybe he isn't... What is that doing here? Tell me you both saw that. That rat thing.
The what?
I don't know. Are there any rodents down here?
Look at where we are and think.
But I could have sworn it was...
Silver?
Took the words right out of my mouth.
There you go, Fyodor. This thing must exist. Loads of the others have seen it, now him as well. So you don't have to trust my faulty eyesight anymore.
Others have seen it?
This mysterious metallic mole cannot be real.
But this isn't the first place where I've seen it, or at least one of these things. There was one of these moles in the warehouse. So what is it doing here? There, you must have seen that.
I told you, there is something down here with us.
But what is it? What is it?
Try and grab it. We could do as a closer look. Maybe that'll help us figure out what it is.
It's moving so fast. Every time I focus on it, it's gone again.
Over there!
Ah, I nearly had it. It's definitely a metal of some sort. This isn't a normal creature.
Still want to catch it?
What else do we do? Run?
Kirill, don't move.
What?
I can see it.
It has stopped right behind you. It's like...
It's like it's smelling, sniffing like a dog.
What do I do?
I'm thinking. No sudden movements.
It wants something.
What?
Certainly looks like it. Some sort of sustenance?
Get it off!
What's it doing?
It wants the Ozeblade.
It can't have... Hey!
Get her, no!
Fyodor! You aren't going to get away from me. Not that easy to knock down. The roof! No way out. Great. Fyodor? Kirill? Can you hear me? So what is so important about this Diozablane? Why does that thing want it so badly? Stay away from me, you thing! Stay away! End of the line. Nowhere to go. Come on, then! Come get me!